Hello and welcome to the Rosa Couture Extreme Park for the men's ski halfpipe finals. This is where the medals will be decided. And this halfpipe run is going to be very entertaining. There's no doubt about it. There you can see it. There's 12 competitors that have made it through from the qualification sessions, and they will get two runs each. The highest score will be their best score, and the top three win the medals. Alongside me is someone who knows how to win a medal in freestyle skiing, and it is Dara Howell, the gold medalist from the skiing slopestyle competition. And Dara, we saw a really entertaining qualification run, and we're going to see an even more entertaining final, I think.
I think it's going to be a fabulous final. You know, they had some training in between, and I know that they'll be pushing to put out their best tricks and show the world what halfpipe skiing is.
So the snow's compact, which is good. It means they should be able to get some decent speed, but the weather coming down is sort of snow, but sort of sleet as well at the same time. So difficult conditions for the run one, which we'll see our 12 competitors run in the reverse of the top 12 order from the qualification session. So that means Aaron Blunk will be the first man out for the USA. The judges down there in that hut at the end of the run, they'll be the ones marking these scores as we take a look at the pipe, which is 6.8 meters high at the sides, 19.5 meters in that run between the two walls at 85 degrees to the ground. And there you can see the weather continuing to come down. Now, obviously, these skiers used to conditions like this, so it shouldn't affect them too much.
Yeah, I mean, it always, with any kind of outdoor sport, you have to be prepared for any weather that comes in, but it definitely does not make it easy, and these guys are out there trying to put down the best runs that they can, and it's tough, but it's going to be good.
So here's a look at the start list. Aaron Blunk will be the first man out there, followed by Thomas Creef. Then we've got Bo James Wells, the New Zealander. And then in the second six, we've perhaps got more of our potential medal contenders. In seventh place, Mike Riddle for Canada. He's going to be looking to try and get a medal. Kevin Rowland, Benoit Valentin, and David Wise and Justin Dory, two of the medal favourites, qualifying in first and second places from the qualification runs. So they're on it. They are in the groove in this half pipe. They know what they need to do, and now it's just a case of delivering it when it matters, which is ultimately the most difficult thing, I imagine.
Yeah, I mean, you go out there and you train and have as much fun as possible, but when it comes to competition, the pressure's on and anything can happen. So, you know, all these guys are prepared and it's going to be a good show.
There are the five judges. The highest and lowest scores will be ignored, and the average of the middle three will be the one that gives them the score. It'll be out of 100, and after the two runs, the highest score that you've accumulated will be the score that counts, and the rankings will be determined by that. So there is Aaron Blunk getting ready to drop. The border's just coming down, and the skis as well, to clear the pipe as much as possible. There you can see the information of the pipe there. But there is 17-year-old Aaron Blunk just going through his moves. Something you're more used to seeing in kind of aerials than in the half pipe.
Yeah, I think he's just trying to get ready, trying to focus in and do what he does best and just put that run down.
I like his poles. Nice bamboo on the outside as he gets ready to run down. The 17-year-old will kick off the men's freestyle ski halfpipe final. Born in Denver in Colorado. Second overall in the World Cup this year. So he's got what it takes to lay down a big run. But we'll see whether he can do it here. Fist bump with the coaches up the top. And the Olympic final for the first time in ski halfpipe is underway.
Starting it off big with the big double cork 1260. Coming in switch now. Trying, really holding his amplitude, landing low, but still able to hold on to it. And Aaron is on fire right now. If he can just hold on to this last
Oh, that's a good run.
Good run, you know, come out with a bang, and that's what half-pipe skiing is all about.
Great stuff from Aaron Blunk then. The 17-year-old really laying it down on that first run. A few landings not totally perfect, but in general, as he gets up to 3.7 meters for that double cork, it was strong.
Going big and sending it at 17 years old, that's first Olympics to make the final. That's huge. I'm happy to see this guy in the final 12 here.
13th in the X Games last month. As we see again his final trick coming off the back there to land switch on the 1080. The coach is pleased. Let's see what the judges think. 68.6 in the first run for Blunk, so I think if he tidies that up a little bit, he could be hitting the sort of late 70s, early 80s with that.
Yeah, I think if he cleans that run up, it's going to be an extremely solid run and could put him up into that medal potential. So that's what he'll be looking for next run, and I'm sure he will do his best to put it down.
Thomas Creef next to go, the 20-year-old Frenchman, born in Grenoble, lives in Alpe d'Huez. And he was fifth in the halfpipe overall in the World Cup last year. He's had a fifth place this season in Breckenridge. Let's see when he's got a lot of encouragement from the French coaches at the top of the hill.
The coaches are trying to fire him up, and let's see what he's got. Starting things off big, landing low. The good thing is that he's got another run, and hopefully he can put it down.
So a shame for Thomas Creef on that first run. As you say, he was going out there big, going out to impress, going out to get the big scores. But the French are on telly, so they're happy.
I think everyone is going to be coming out swinging, and you know, it's the Olympic final. It's kind of all in, right?
Absolutely. Let's have a look at that again as he tries to throw the double. And he, just lands too far down.
Just landing low and really forward and not able to hold on to it.
How difficult is it to spot your landing in normal conditions compared to the snow we're seeing here?
It's hard, you know. It's you gotta look for it and really be on it. And I mean, in the pipe, it's definitely harder because your landing space is so much smaller than on a jump, right? So these guys do such a great job at making it look effortless.
4.6 the score then for Thomas Creef. As we now look at Bo James Wells, the New Zealander, 18 years old, competed in the halfpipe as well here. In the slope style as well, I should say. 11th in Cardrona in 2013, his best World Cup performance for Bo James. His brother Josiah is out in the final as well. The other brother, Byron, not entering the competition in the end, but in he drops.
Getting styly right away. Keeping that amplitude big. Into the double. Does he do back-to-back doubles again? Changing it up. Into the left nine. Right seven. Really, really showing the judges that style. And it doesn't look like he's too stoked on it, but it was a solid, clean run.
So Bo James Wells puts down his first run of the two he will get here in the competition. So there was the double flare, which was a good way to start. But the judge is looking for variation. If you go down, even if you do, well, maybe not if you do, you know, five double corks, but in general, they're looking for the variation, aren't they, as he scores 62.
Yeah, they're looking for the forward takeoffs, the switch takeoff, the right, the left, different variations of grabs. You know, that's what happens when it's based on an overall impression, and these guys do such a great job at showing the judges that they are capable of doing so much more than just the same trick over and over again.
Antti-Jussi Kemppainen, the next man to drop in. The 24-year-old Finn scored 79.4 in his qualification run. Got his first World Cup victory this season in Cardrona in New Zealand. The Finn drops in.
First guy to drop in Swish so far. Holding on to his amplitude. Into the doubles. Nice landing. A little low, but it was really good. Into the right nine. Into the left 900. One more hit, maybe. Into the other way. Double flare. Nice run.
Antti-Jussi Kemppainen setting out his stall in his first run of two. And where is this going to be? This may well put him at the top of the pile. The highest score we've had so far. Aaron Blunk on 68.6. Coming in switch into that seven. And there was the first of the two doubles that he pulled on the way down. Spectacular stuff to see these skiers in these slow-mo pictures with the snow coming down as well. And then there was the second double on the final trick. Strong run. Will it be enough to get him into the 80s? Maybe not quite. 74.4 for the Finn. That puts him up to the top of the four we've had so far. As we now move on to the second of our three New Zealanders who have made it through to the final. This man is Lyndon Sheehan up at the top there. 25 years old. His sister competes for Australia. He competes for New Zealand.
Yeah, she will be competing in the half pipe, the girls' half pipe, on Thursday, I believe it is.
Absolutely so.
Kind of cool to have a brother and sister in the Olympics.
Absolutely, and in different countries as well.
Yeah, interesting. Doesn't happen every day, though.
Twelfth in Copper Mountain, his best result of the season so far.
Sometimes I feel like I'm way more nervous for these guys.
So in comes Lyndon, 25 years old.
Coming in switch to the first hit. Into the big right side 540. Holding his amplitude. Right side 900, back-to-back 900s. Into the 1080, able to hold on to it, great run.
I thought he was looking in trouble about halfway down that 1080, but he gets it landed in the end. And when we're saying 900, we're basically referring to the degrees of rotation as they come off into the air, going through 900 degrees, and this was the, was this a switch 900? Let's have a look. No, I think he went through to the 1080 on that one. And this is the last jump, I think, where it looked as though he perhaps didn't quite have it. He was stretching on his way down into the landing.
Able to hold on to it, though.
Exactly.
Nice and smooth.
The judges are looking for clean, smooth runs here. And let's see what the score is for Lyndon Sheehan. Lives in Wanaka in New Zealand, as do the majority of the New Zealand snow sports team. And with that little mistake towards the end, it's 55.2 for Sheehan. And that puts him in fourth place out of our five skiers so far. Next up, Noah Bowman, the 21-year-old. The first of three Canadians competing in the competition this evening.
Yeah, first Canadian. I think we can expect a really clean, styly run from Noah right now. And it's nice to see him in this Olympic final.
And we could see a lot of switch here too from Bowman.
Starting things off big, straight into the switch he goes. Nice and styly. think he's just going to try and put down a clean run, and hopefully he'll be able to really step it up and maybe put in that switch double on his second run. Nice run.
Decent from Noah Bowman. But as we say, I think he's got some more in there. So we'll see what the judges say for Noah Bowman as we see getting some big air, 3.7. We saw 4.5 meters in the qualification runs. Really spectacular stuff here in the ski halfpipe final in the men's competition. First time it's ever been in the Olympic Winter Games, and it's 80.4 for Noah Bowman. That puts him up to the top. A strong run.
He's stoked. He's it's a first run down and good score. I know he's going to be looking for a little bit more of the second run, though.
Mike Riddle next up. The 27-year-old Canadian, so these two Canadians running back-to-back before we end up with Justin Dory, the Canadian. But here then comes Riddle, the 27-year-old from Edmonton. First overall last year.
Trying to get as much speed as possible coming into the snowy pipe. Beautiful double cork 12. Back-to-back double cork 12s, able to hold on to it. Into the bow and arrow, flat five. Kind of getting a little bit of transition bump there, but still able to put a run down to his feet. So, you know, first run done, one to go.
So where will that score Mike Riddle? A strong run up at the top of the pipe. Inspired by Jean-Luc Brassard winning gold in Lillehammer in 94. That's what made him want to be involved in the Olympic Games. There you can see the second double where he just landed on the side of the pipe there a little.
You can see Mike, he always gets those grabs really well, especially in the bow and arrow. You see how much control he has over that trick, and he makes it look really easy, and it's really not.
So let's see what the judges have got to say then. The five of them.
Parents waiting patiently.
Everyone waiting patiently. Is this going to be good enough to move him into the top three? Mike Riddle. Third place for the moment, 71.4. So I think he knows if he cleans that run up a bit, he can be a contender here. So there's our top three, as we have had our seven runners out of the 12. Bowman, Kampainen and Riddle. As next up, we have the second of the Wells brothers through, Josiah, the 23-year-old.
It's so cool to see his family up top with them, just supporting him on and just having as much fun as possible. You know, it's what the sport is all about, and it's nice to see his family up there.
Won the World Cup slopestyle event in Gstaad. Competed in the slopestyle as well here at the Olympic Winter Games, but in he drops into the halfpipe.
I think we're gonna see Jossie get really technical, but really styly as well, and he stomps that dub 12 into the right 900, into the double flare. His landings are spectacular. Into the switch, trying to hold his amplitude. Fabulous run right there.
Really good run from Josiah Wells. And that will surely put him near the top of the leaderboard so far. The 23-year-old who lives in Wanaka, enjoying himself out there. So clean.
Landing high on the tranny there, as you can see.
that grab again. No.
We can hear him saying he's missed a grab somewhere, which seems to be frustrating him every time. But that is going to be surely a score good enough to put him in contention.
Hi, Mom.
85.6 for Josiah Wells. That puts him up in first place at the moment. To win gold, though, do you think we'll be needing to see somewhere in the 90s?
I think we will definitely start to see some 90s. You know, it's the final, and everyone's going for it. So the 90s are for sure going to happen, and it could be from this guy right here.
Kevin Rowland. The 24-year-old Frenchman was runner-up in Aspen at the X Games last month. He's won the European X Games in teen back in 2011. And again, the French coach is really trying to psych him up.
Just getting him fired up, ready to go. Starting things off big, straight into the switch. Trying to hold his amplitude. Into the dub 12. Making sure that he's getting all those grabs. Solid run from Kevin right there. I think we're gonna see a pretty good score.
Great stuff from Kevin Rowland. Won the Grand Prix event in Park City this year. Second in Copper Mountain. Last season, yet to get a World Cup win under his belt, but second place in the X Games and strong performances in the European X Games, as there we see
going
the first
huge
of the double, yeah. And switching it round as well on the landing.
Losing maybe a little bit of amplitude there, but still able to hold on to it through the to the next hit. Holding that grab all the way around.
Here's the reaction from the coaches. I'm sure French is good
enough
for that one.
French coaches are stoked.
88.6 for Kevin Rowland. That moves him up to the top of our nine competitors so far. Just three left to drop. He's saying, I've still got a second run. I've got more than that. And next up is his French teammate, Benoit Valentin. The 21-year-old. Fifth in the X Games this year. He's done well to hit that 87 in the qualification session. If he hits that again, he'll only be in second place on this first run. But you want to get a solid score in this first run, or do you go totally for broke?
I don't know. I don't know what strategy to take exactly. I think you go for it, and you have two runs. So if you mess up the first run, there's the second run, because you train for this. It's the Olympics. It's kind of all in or nothing. But we've seen some solid, clean first runs, and I know that the guys are going to step it up the second run.
In comes Valentin.
Big ol' flare to start things off. Going huge.
Oh.
Not able to hold on to it, unfortunately.
That was some incredible height out of the side of the pipe from Benoit Valentin. There's the French fan club down there. And so that's not going to be a big score for Valentin. So he'll have it all to do on his second run if he wants to get amongst the front runners. Because this is going to put him right down at the bottom. Maybe not quite at the bottom, because Thomas Creef, his countryman, hit 4.6. 4.5.
Huge. Just landing a little deep and a little too far forward that he's not able to hold on to it. Getting that grab all the way around, though. I'm sure we'll see him stomp this next run.
To be 4.1 meters off the side of the pipe, that's almost 12 meters in the air and control the lesser rotations is a real skill, as Valentin scores 10. David Wise next to drop in. Multiple X Games champion in the halfpipe, including this year in Colorado. 88.4 his score from qualification. He's about to drop in one of the gold medal favorites, if not the gold medal favorite.
This could be a medal winning run right this second. Trying to get as much speed as he can dropping in, just because the pipe is getting full of snow and the conditions are not so perfect out there. Ending things off with the double 12. Very nice run from David.
You can tell by his reaction, he is pleased with how that one went. The 23-year-old from Reno is looking for a big score here.
Very nice double 12, holding on to the grab, getting lots of amplitude. I think the score is going to be huge.
So David Wise with a really strong run. Should be enough to put him towards the top. As he comes towards the finish line, and that was an impressive run.
An impressive run from David right there. And it shows right there, he joins the 90 club. It has started already.
So, 92 for David Wise. That puts him right to the top, and that's going to be a really tough score to beat. Justin Dory can do it, though. He hit 91.6 in his qualification run. And here comes the 25-year-old Canadian leading the World Cup. Number one in the world. Let's see what he's got. The final of our 12 runners. They'll all get a second run. In comes Justin Dory.
Starting things off with the right dub 12. Into a big left side 1080. Into the switch, holding his amplitude really well. Right into, no.
And that's such a shame for Justin Dory. The arm up in the air saying, I'm all right. But he's going to have a lot to do on this second run, because that was looking strong, wasn't it?
It was good, yeah. Starting things off with the right double and then pretty much getting right into the left double. It's huge. Those are massive tricks, and we're glad that he's okay, and we'll hopefully he'll be able to put it down next run.
So here's a look at the replays. See just, him throwing himself
yeah,
into
just
it.
Yeah, didn't pop off the wall quite hard enough, and he almost had it. He could have landed a little high on the tranny there, but just kind of clipped the deck a little bit, and unfortunately could not hold on to it.
Wasn't far off. And there's the reaction of the coaches up at the top of the pipe, and that's not going to be a big score for Justin Dory. It's 20.4 for the Canadian. He'll have it all to do in the second run here of the men's ski halfpipe final. So our 12 competitors have run. They've been given their scores, but then they get a second run, and it's the highest of the two scores that counts. Let's have a look at it after run number one. David Wise with a 92. That's going to take a lot of beating. Kevin Rowland in second place with 88.6. Josiah Wells currently in that bronze medal position with an 85.6. Noah Bowman, Antti Jussi Kampainen, and Mike Riddle completing the top six. And then behind them in seventh place, Aaron Blunk, Bo James Wells, Lyndon Sheehan, Justin Dory, Benoit Valentin, and Thomas Creef completing our 12 runners. Those bottom three having major falls. Sheehan and Wells having half falls, let's call them, on the run.
It's going to go by quick. I can't believe we're already done the first run. We're in medal contention right now, and it's pretty crazy that this is the first ever Winter Olympics for halfpipe skiing, and the winner will be made soon.
Absolutely. So the course workers get to work before the second run of competition here in Sochi. Up at the top, Aaron Blunk, ready to drop in his final run in the men's ski halfpipe.
This is it, you know? I thought I was nervous before, but the nerves are really bad.
And is it worse here than when you're at the top of the slope style run?
I think it's worse watching these guys compete than it is competing myself. And I get nervous when I compete myself, so this is crazy.
At what point do these guys, do you think, lose the nerves? Are they standing at the top nervous, but then once they drop in, you're just in the zone, or is it nerves all the way down?
Yeah, you know, standing at the top before the starter tells you to go, the nerves are insane. Insane. But as soon as you drop in, you focus in on what has to be done, and the nerves just, you kind of forget about them almost.
And how conscious are you when you're going down the runs, you know? And so, you know, when David Wise is coming to his last trick, is he thinking, I really need to pull this off if I want to win the gold, or is it less sort of engaging than that?
Yeah, for me, it's my coach always is one feature at a time. He's been like that from the start, so I've kind of learned that one feature at a time is really important, and it's not over until it's over. So I'm hoping right now Blunk can hold on to this and fight through it to the end and put down a great run.
Currently in seventh place, the youngest man in the final at 17 years of age. The man from Colorado drops into the pipe.
Aaron is holding on to it very well right now. Perfect. one more trick, and he stops it. Great run from Aaron right there. We're gonna see him jump quite a few spots, I hope. And you know, he's got to be pretty proud of himself right now. He did not have a great first run, and he just put it down.
68.6 on his first run. You're hearing Dara Howell here with me in the commentary box, Olympic gold medalist in the women's slopestyle competition in freestyle skiing. As we look at the run here of Aaron Blunk.
Going huge on the alley-oop double, landing low, but as you can see, he's able to hold on to it. Going big into the right side 1080. You can see his excitement there. Yeah. You can see the excitement from the coaches, and hopefully the score will show.
So currently in seventh place, Aaron Blunk, but there's a couple of men below him in the standings at the moment who are capable of hitting the big scores. He hit 72 in his qualification run. Let's see what he's got in this second run of the final. Will it be enough to move him up from seventh place? The judges in there making their decisions. They've been taking their time with their decisions. First run, 68.6. 79.4 on run two for Aaron. A little nod. I think he was hoping that it might be a little higher than that.
Yeah, I thought it definitely would have been a little bit higher, but clearly the judges saw something that we missed, and it's a little disappointing, but I mean, 17 and being in fifth right now is incredible.
Thomas Cleef next up. The Frenchman went down on his, well, even before his first trick, he dropped into the pipe switch and then just got caught in the snow. Let's see what happens this time.
Going big on the dub 12. The alley-oop. Trying to hold his amplitude as best as he can on the switch. Gaining it back up a little bit. Into the last, just not able to hold on to it. Hopefully he will be okay. And he's good. Good, the hand wave.
Yeah. Great to see the thumbs up from the Frenchman, but with that score, he may well be finishing 12th place in the Olympic final here. Actually, his score might take him higher than Dorian Valentin, actually, despite the fall, but we'll wait and see. He took a bit of hit on that right side, didn't he?
Yeah, I'm sure he's a little disappointed, and we all know that he's such a great skier, and unfortunate that he was not able to put it down.
Second in the Euro X Games 2 years ago. But it's always difficult to come out of those doubles and land switch. Because spotting your landing going forwards is hard enough, I imagine, but trying to land it switch must be a real challenge.
Yeah, he just kind of lost his amplitude and didn't quite get it all the way around and landed a little low and just couldn't hold on to it. But, I mean, it was a great run up to that point.
So it's 10th place for now for Thomas Cleef. The Frenchman scores 28.6. And he looks a little bit uncomfortable, as you can imagine, after that fall. So there's our top three as it stands. All of those having only done one run. Next up is Bo James Wells, currently in eighth place with a 62. There you can see the hug from Josiah. Fist bump for the Olympics.
You know, I think Bo's just out there having as much fun as he can, just like his brother, and his skiing really shows it.
Yeah, absolutely. So here comes the New Zealander in his second run in the Olympic final.
Big 540 to start things off. Straight into the doubles again. Does he do back-to-back? Yes, he does. Lands them both very cleanly. into the right side seven, coming in switch, holding his amplitude quite nicely there. Yeah. Great run from Bo.
Really nice style as well on that final trick, and he looks like he enjoyed it.
The smile is there.
Yeah, when I don't think I've ever not seen it there on Bo's face. So let's have a look back at some of those doubles. There was the first, and then is this into the second? Sure is.
The family is stoked up top.
So let's see what the judges give it. 62 on his first run for the 18-year-old, second youngest man in the competition. You can see the breath coming out from the athletes, I think for the first time in this Olympic Winter Games. It's been so warm up in the mountains, but with the snow coming down, it's a little chillier this evening as Bo James Wells waits for the scores to come in. Now, this should get him better than his 62. Will it be good enough for the 80s? Just about 80 for Bo James Wells. Fifth place for him.
Very
the smile run. Gets wider. Antti Jussi Kemppainen, the Finn, currently seventh place at the moment with a 74.4. Taking his first World Cup win this season in New Zealand in Cardrona. So, in a good vein of form, number five in the world at the moment. Let's see if he can launch himself into medal contention here in Sochi.
Coming in switch. Big double flare. Into the right side 900. Into the left side 900, back-to-back 900s. And into the other way, double flare. Solid run from AJ.
Gets it done on that final trick. As he came towards it, I didn't know if he was gonna have enough amplitude out the side, but he got it done. And that'll be a decent score, 74.4 his first run. Got 79.4 in qualification, so he's capable of more. But all these runs really strong as well. They're all so clean. It must be really difficult for the judges to sort of find fault with them. It's really impressive.
Yeah, they're all out there trying to do their best and put down the best runs they can and show the judges, you know, they deserve to be in that top spot.
And you can see him coming down off the final trick, the smile on the face. Will there be a smile after the judges' scores come in? 74.4 at the moment for the 24-year-old Finn from Helsinki. Second overall in 2007. Fingers crossed, he'll be having those fingers crossed for a little while longer because there's no score from the judges just yet.
They're really taking their time on this, making sure that they're getting it right. You know, it's tough to be down there waiting for your score, but you really want to make sure that the judges see everything and get every little detail in there.
There they are. So will that be better than 74.4 for Kemppainen, currently in seventh spot? It's better, but he stays in seventh place, a 78.2. He seems pleased. And that is seventh at the moment in the Olympic Winter Games for Kemppainen, but a couple more skiers to come down behind him. Lyndon Sheehan is the first of them, currently in ninth spot, 55.2, so not a representative score in that first run. He's capable of 80s, as he's proved in qualification. The 25-year-old from Wanaka, about to drop into the pipe.
Yeah,
Here he comes for Lyndon Sheehan's second run in this Olympic final.
Landing a little low there, but able to hold on to it. Trying to keep his amplitude as high as possible, which he shows right there. Into the right side 900, so back-to-back 900s. Into the 1080.
Good strong run from Lyndon Sheehan. Thumbs up. He's happy.
It's nice to see a lot of them come down with smiles on their face, and I think it really kind of shows what the sport is about, and we're all just out there having as much fun as possible and showing the world what our sport is about, and these guys are doing a tremendous job of doing that right now.
The first ever ski halfpipe in the Olympic Winter Games. There you can see the 1080 coming down from Lyndon Sheehan. Thumbs up.
Coach is happy.
Yep. High fives all around. So let's see what the judges reckon. It'll be better than his 55.2. He needs to get above 85.6 to get into the top medals positions. Above the 80s to get towards the top five. So let's see what the judges decide for the 25-year-old New Zealander. All of these men, of course, in their first Olympic Winter Games. 55.2 in run one. And it's 72.6 in run two. So that puts him up in eighth place.
Nice improvement.
Definitely the pressure on in that second run with not a great score in run number one. So there's our top four at the moment. All of them still to run again. Next up, Noah Bowman, currently in fourth spot, the 21-year-old Canadian. The youngest Canadian in the final.
He had a solid first run, so he's just looking to clean it up, and maybe we'll see that switch double. I know he's thrown it a couple times this year in competition, so I'm hoping we see it, and that'll definitely boost up his score. Noah's just going as big as he can, trying to keep a lot of it switched, a lot of variety going on. Technical stuff, getting those grabs really, really good, and just holding on. Another solid run from Noah Bowman right there.
So his first run was good enough to put him in that fourth place on 80.4.
Wanted to show you more, I'm sorry.
Sounded like he wanted to show you his switch double, but
the conditions are tough,
yeah.
You know. They're all out there just trying to put down the best run they can, and Noah did a fabulous run right there. Really clean, really technical, lots of variety, and, you know, he just he went big, and it's tough to do when the weather's like this.
So why is this snow affecting, you know, the conditions and the amplitude these guys are getting?
Yeah, so, I mean, the snow is falling into the pipe, and it's, I mean, there's not very many people riding it, so it's collecting snow, and it's building up, and it gets hard, you know? Your skis need to be fast, and you just need to try and maintain that all the way down the pipe.
And the snow slows it down, so it's difficult to get the speed up. Next up then is going to be Mike Riddle. He's currently down in ninth place at the moment with a 71.4. Ninth place with a 71. That shows you how competitive it is here, as in he drops.
Starting things off big with that double 12. Into the right side, double 12. So back-to-back 12s in a row. That's the first time we've seen that in this competition. Going big, getting that bow and arrow. Into the switch.
Strong
Very
run.
Impressive run right there.
So that'll move Mike Riddle potentially up into medal contention. 92 is the biggest score so far.
Giving his teammate a hug there.
Noah Bowman running over to embrace Riddle. Let's have another look then.
You see he just locks onto that grab and holds it throughout the entire rotation.
The landing's so smooth. It looks, like you say, so easy on the landings. No
yeah.
dramas.
Mike is really good at making sure that he rides the pipe well and lands high on that transition. And we just saw it right there. Mike Riddle at his finest.
So it'll be better than his 71.4. He knows that. But where will the judges decide to put the Canadian? Ranked number 3 in the world at the moment.
Hit.
So the score's coming in. David Wise at the top with 92, and it's 90.6 for Mike Riddle. Great
Mike
run.
Riddle as well joins the 90 club. Impressive run right there.
Up into second place for him. Still a couple of strong competitors to come, but only 5. But there you can see Wise up at the top, 92. Mike Riddle, second place now in 90.6. Next up, Josiah Wells, the second of the brothers competing. Byron was meant to compete, but unfortunately couldn't make the qualification phase. Didn't start in that. As we now see the 23-year-old, the oldest of the three brothers, about to drop in. He's currently in fourth spot on 85.6. Needs to get up to the later 80s, basically 89, to get into the medal positions. In comes Josiah Wells.
Winding up with that big double cork 12. Into the right side 900. Into the double flare. He's able to hold his amplitude really well throughout the entire pipe. And another solid run from Josie right there.
Really good stuff from Josiah Wells. Loads of variation in the run as well. Congratulations between him and Mike Riddle. 85.6, the first run score for Wells. Let's have a look at it again. There was the double 12, stays nice and low on the landing. Gets the rotations in at the end. Really strong stuff from Josiah Wells. Was it as clean as his first run, though, where he scored 85.6? No, say the judges, 78.4. So that's still fourth place for Josiah Wells. No medal for him here in Sochi. 4 skiers left. Mike Riddle still in that silver medal spot at the moment.
The waiting game now.
Yeah. What is that waiting like down at the bottom as we get ready to see Kevin Rowland come down, who's currently in third place, but waiting to see everyone come down must be nervy.
Yeah, it's crazy, you know. Everyone in the final is good enough for a podium position, and you never know what the day is going to bring. So definitely having to wait to find out where you're going to find it, like where you're going to end up is tough, and all you can do is wait, though, so...
Kevin Rowland with his now customary fiery send-off into the cold of the pipe. 88.5 on his first run, but here come the doubles straight away.
Losing a little bit of amplitude there. Hopefully he'll be able to gain it back. And he does into the second double. Does he set up for the switch double?
Oh, he did. But he couldn't quite get it down.
Not able to hold on to it.
Still in that third place, Kevin Rowland, with an 88.6. fantastic to see him going for the switch double at the end there. And we'll wait and see what the judges say, but with that fall, it won't be an improvement, obviously, on the 88.6. But if he could have got that down, that would have been huge.
Yeah, so you could see Kevin kind of going for the grab there and missing it. And the judges are really trying to pay attention to that. You need to grab onto your ski every jump that you take, every trick. And as you can see, he missed another one there, which is unfortunate. But it was good effort. It was nice to see someone try the switch double.
Exactly, in difficult conditions. Kevin Rowland went for it. Hasn't paid off for now, but he's still in bronze medal position. 29.8 for the Frenchman, with only three riders to drop. And that means David Wise definitely has an Olympic medal. It'll be at least a bronze for David Wise. As next up comes Benoit Valentin. 10 in his first run. I think he'll be looking to improve on that.
And he is definitely capable of it.
5th in the X Games this year. Had a second place in a World Cup event in La Plagne back in 2011. Started skiing aged 11. Picked up the half pipe age 15. And now he's in an Olympic final, gunning for a medal. All or nothing for Valentin now. Down in 12th place out of the 12 riders at the moment. In he drops.
Starting things off with a big flare. Into the huge alley-oop and stomping it this time. That's where he had trouble last time. Into the big right side 900.
Almost getting that double down. So close for Benoit Valentin. It's going to improve his score from 10, no doubt about it. But just inches away. He didn't go down on that last double, did he? But
no,
it wasn't perfect.
Almost had it. Just lost a little bit of amplitude and wasn't able to hold on to it.
So the 21-year-old Frenchman will have enjoyed his time here at the Olympics. No doubt about that. But will this be good enough to move him up anywhere, really? Let's have a look at the landing again from this double. So close, just that left ski getting
just
away from him.
A little bit of an edge in that tough snow.
And it's 61 for Benoit Valentin down in 10th place. And just, those are the finest of margins, aren't they? So that means that David Wise and Mike Riddle both guaranteed medals here. At least a silver for David Wise. At least a bronze for Mike Riddle. Next to come is David Wise. And he needs to go big, because he knows Justin Dory's coming up next, who's got nothing to lose.
Exactly, yeah. You know, David is sitting in a comfy position right now, but he knows Justin's coming behind him, so he's going to push it as much as he can and try and up that 92. And he is definitely capable of doing that.
So in drops David Wise, currently at the top of the leaderboard. Oh, and he goes down. Just hitting the deck. Now it's the waiting game for David Wise. He's still in that gold medal position, but there's one skier to come, the number one in the world.
It is all up to Justin now, and we will see what happens.
USA versus Canada for the gold medal here. So those are our three medal men at the moment, David Wise, Mike Riddle, and Kevin Rowland. But still to come is Justin Dory. Let's have a look at this again.
Just clipping the deck and...
But he's still in that gold medal spot, David Wise. The second score is a 3.4. but he's still number one for the time being. So this is it. He will win the gold medal in the men's ski halfpipe unless Justin Dorey goes bigger than 92. And they're all coming out to have a watch. This is going to be dramatic from Justin Dorey, the number one in the world at the moment. Won the World Cup event in Calgary, fourth in Copper Mountain, sixth in Breckenridge. The 25-year-old Canadian is the last man to drop.
I'm anxious just sitting here. I cannot imagine what is going through Justin's mind and the three boys down on the bottom waiting to find out if they're Olympic medalists or not.
Currently 12th on the leaderboard out of the 12 finalists, Justin Dorey. But he's got what it takes to hit the 90s. Can he do it now when it matters in the first ever halfpipe ski Olympic final?
Starting things off with the big right side double. Going huge.
Oh, just leaning back on the way down.
Not able to hold on to it.
And that's not enough for Justin Dorey. David Wise, the American, is the men's ski halfpipe Olympic champion. The first ever gold medalist in the halfpipe. Reigning X Games champion is now the reigning Olympic champion as well. Wonderful performance from Wise. Such a shame for Justin Dorey, though.
Such a shame, you know. He's got the tricks. He's got it all. It's sad to see him not be able to put it down.
But it means a silver for Mike Riddle for the Canadian team. The 27-year-old picks up second place, and Kevin Rowland, the Frenchman, will get the bronze medal. But David Wise, the 23-year-old from Reno, is the Olympic champion. And what must Justin Dorey be feeling? It's 14.2 on that second run, 12th place. Can you read the world number one, 12th overall in the Olympic Games. But there's the handshake. There is our third place man, Kevin Rowland. The Frenchman getting plenty of hugs and support because a bronze medal position finish, superb. But it's the American, David Wise, who has the gold medal in halfpipe, and thoroughly deserved as well after that first run.
Great first run, yes. Definitely deserved, you know. And the other two skied well along with everyone else in the finals. You know, they struggled with these conditions, and they still put on a great show.
So there's Kevin Rowland making his way back. He'll have to do the flower ceremony in a few moments' time. But David Wise just struggling to keep it. So the end of the first ever Olympic final in men's ski halfpipe sees David Wise become the Olympic champion. Mike Riddle, silver for Canada, and the Frenchman Kevin Rowland finishing in third place. Good performance from Josiah Wells, just missing out by 1 point on an Olympic medal. 3 points on an Olympic medal. That's my maths for you. Noah Bowman finishing in fifth place with Bo James Wells in sixth. So two top six finishes for the Wells brothers, which is great to see. In seventh place, we had our first man to drop in, Aaron Blunk hitting a 79.4 on his second run. Antti Jussi Kemppainen, Lyndon Sheehan, Benoit Valentin, Thomas Kreef completing the top 12, and then Justin Dorey. It was all down to him on the final run to usurp David Wise from the gold position spot, but he was unable to do it, and the Canadian has to be content with 12th place in the Olympic classifications, despite being number one in the world at the moment. So David Wise is the Olympic champion as we now get ready for the flower ceremony here at the Rosa Couture Extreme Park. So there you can see the podium readied as the Olympians are about to come out. The flower ceremony for the first ever freestyle skiing men's half pipe here in Sochi 2014 is underway. There are our top three: David Wise, Mike Riddle, Kevin Rowland, about to receive their flowers for finishing in the top three of the first ever half pipe in the Olympic Winter Games. And freestyle skiing with the half pipe and the slopestyle making a stronger impact every year on the games. It's been great for the sport as we see the FIS council member who's about to give out the flowers, Michel Vion. But it's great to see freestyle skiing get more and more involved in the Olympic Winter Games, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, it's amazing that we're here today and that we're able to show the world our sport, and there's so many people that we have to thank for that. But Sarah Burke was a major reason that we're here today, and that women's slopestyle and halfpipe skiing, as well as men's, is in the Olympics. And you know, these games really are hers, and we know that she's shining down on us, very proud, very happy, and you know, we wish that she could be here, and I know that Mike will be really, really thinking about her right now as he steps onto that Olympic podium.
Third place for Kevin Rowland then in the men's ski half pipe. The 24-year-old Frenchman, second in the X Games last month, now third in the Olympic Winter Games. In second place, number three in the world, Mike Riddle climbs onto the second step of the podium. Number one in the world last year, now number two in the Olympic Winter Games. David Wise hasn't had the strongest of seasons World Cup-wise, but he's had a superb year. He's multiple X Games champion, and now he's the first ever Olympic Winter Games champion in freestyle skiing men's halfpipe. The top step of the podium, the 23-year-old from Reno, David Wise.
What a moment. You can see the excitement.
Great moment, I imagine.
I can only sit here and smile myself, you know, just what a moment, really, is all I have to say.
David Wise, the winner of the men's ski half pipe here in Sochi 2014. No doubt his wife and his two-year-old daughter will be over the moon with this achievement as well. Onto the top step, your top three. David Wise, Mike Riddle, and Kevin Rowland are the three medal winners from the first ever ski half pipe here in the Olympic Winter Games at Sochi 2014. And they all look a bit overcome, you know, can't quite compute what's going on.
Yeah, it's such a whirlwind feeling. You can't even describe it. It goes by so fast, and you know, all you can really do is sit back and smile.
So there they are making their way away from the podium after the flower ceremony. They'll pick up their medals in a separate ceremony down on the coastal cluster in front of all the fans that come to see the medals ceremony presentations. But what a first event it has been. Really exciting and really tense as well, with Justin Dory taking that final run. Big credit to him for adding to the drama. There's no doubt about it. It was all or nothing for him. And unfortunately, he's come away with nothing but a 12th place finish.
Still an Olympian.
Yep, still an Olympian.
Which is an incredible achievement.
Which is an easy thing for a gold medalist to say, as they as they now get ready with their flags to head back to the podium for a couple more photo shoots. But what a strong performer David Wise is at 23 years of age. He's still young. He's still got a lot of skiing left in him. But he's not becoming unbeatable, but he's winning pretty much everything there is to win at the moment.
He's a very consistent skier, and you know he works hard to be that way. So it's good to see.
So a wonderful debut here in the men's ski half pipe. Dara, what are your final thoughts on the competition we've just seen?
My final thoughts, you know, what a good show. What a first great appearance for half pipe skiing in the Olympics. And I'm sure that this is just the beginning, that we can expect many more great Olympics from now for hopefully forever. But yeah, it's good, and I'm glad to see a Canadian on the podium along with everyone else.
Thank you very much to Dara Howell, Olympic gold medalist, for joining us in the commentary box. It's David Wise who's the first Olympic champion in ski halfpipe.